Good afternoon everyone, my name is Lakshmikant. I completed my post-graduation in English from Kakatiya University Nirmal PG Center in 2004. Since then I have been working as a teaching faculty. From 2004 to 2009 I worked as a junior college lecturer at Shapur Nagar Gautam Junior College. I joined St. Martin Junior College in 2009. Since then I have been handling BTech first year theory and lab classes, BTech third year final year lab classes, and MBA Business Communication in English classes. Today, I am going to teach professional English, which is prescribed as a textbook for BTech first year students in this module 5 titled How a Chinese Billionaire Built Her Fortune. In this, we come to know about a Chinese billionaire who faced many difficulties in her personal life at the beginning of her personal career. Later, with the help of her family members and relatives, she started her own company named Lens Technology, and later on she earned very much popularity and built a fortune. At present she owns $27 billion estate in Hong Kong. Here, the present story of Mrs. Zhou Kanfei. Suggests entire the youth as well as many people how to take the grip over the personal life, how to build confidence and personality development and continue her profession, anyone's profession. Here, in this particular module, we come to know about, apart from the lesson, understanding the technical vocabulary, exercises on common errors and grammar part, and reading comprehension and exercises, and the final report writing. The lesson, the opening paragraph of this particular lesson, meet Zhou Kanfei, the world's richest self-made woman. She is founder of Lens Technology and accounts a $27 billion estate in Hong Kong among her acquisitions, but she is the most at home on the floor of her factory, dipping her hands in a tray of water to ensure it is the right of temperature, or taking the place of work of her technician for a while. If you met her, you would instantly notice her neatness of appearance, her round all like glasses and her cherubic face. And here, how Zhou Kanfei started her life, we can't know about in this particular open paragraph. Even though here she became worldwide popular, she never preferred to deliver any particular interviews. And here, at present, she owns that $27 billion estate in Hong Kong. And here, even though she had that popularity and was the richest position, she is not never feels proud of that particular status. And here, she is very down-to-earth woman. She practices her simplicity by verifying entire her work, professional work as well as personal life, personal life action. And here, about her personal appearance is presented in this opening paragraph. The youngest of three children, Kanfei was born in a tiny village in China. She lost her mother when she was 5. Her father was a skilled craftsman. He lost his eyesight and finger in an industrial accident. Young Kanfei helped her family raise pigs and ducks for their livelihood. Even though she was the youngest of the family of those three siblings, she happened to take responsibility at the early age as she lost her mother at the age of 5. And at the age of 9, her father happened to meet an accident, and in which that industrial accident he lost his eyesight and his finger was injured. These things forced her to take the responsibility, and she took care of the pigs and ducks and financial help. And here, despite being a brilliant student, Kanti dropped out of school at the age of 16. She landed a job that required her to work from 8 a.m. to 12 a.m. for Shingla. The hours were long and the work monotonous. After 3 months, she decided to quit. She wrote her letter of resignation to her boss, in which she complained of long hours and the boredom. But she also said that she was grateful for the job and was willing to learn more. Her boss was impressed with the letter. He asked her to stay on and promoted her. In spite of her intelligence, even though she was an intelligent girl at schooling and that in school education, her financial issues, her personal life made her to quit her education. And at the age of 16, she stopped her studies and worked in a polishing glass factory from 8 a.m. to 12 a.m., total 16 hours per day. And the task or the responsibilities were for just monotonous, no change in her work at all. And it's the same thing she conveyed to her boss in the letter of resignation, mentioning so that the work hours were long and it was quite boring for her. And here, seeing this frankness, her boss allowed her to continue for a while. Later on, she was promoted in her profession. When she had saved enough money, she took the help of her relatives and set up a workshop for making watch lenses. Much of what she knew about making lenses was self-taught. She now began to try out different ways of improving the quality of the lenses that she sold. She began to acquire a reputation for making the finest watch lenses available in the market. Along the way, she married and had a child. She then divorced, married again, and had another child. With a humble beginning, she started her career, and later on in that profession, what she saved as that amount, with the help of her relatives, she added some more amount and started her own workshop named Lens Technology. And here, what she earned, it was self-taught as she practiced well and acquired knowledge. And here, she began to produce quality glasses for that watches. And here, within a short span of time, she got the reputation, that popularity, that she could produce the quality glasses. And here, in her personal life, she was married to her senior most staff member and had a child. Okay, she got a female baby. Later on, here within short span of time, she was divorced. Later again, she married her colleague and got his son, who is now 7 years old. Her son is staying at the $27 million estate in Hong Kong. The advent of the mobile phone made Ms. Zhou a billionaire. In 2003, she was still making watch lenses when she received a call from the mobile giant Motorola. They wanted her to make screens for mobile phones. Until then, mobile screens were made of plastic, but the glass would be more resistant to scratches and provide sharp images for text and multimedia. Zhou got on board and created the screens for Motorola's RUG V3. In this particular paragraph, we come to know about the word advent, the arrival, or the start, the beginning. It was a new style that till then, in 2003 here, she was still producing that watch lenses, finding the quality of those watch lenses. Till then, mobile phones were made of plastic. And here, they were affected with the scratches on that particular scars on that particular mobile phones. Then they wanted to fix that order with Jack and Faye, and she got the opportunity to make screens for Motorola. Then it was the first offer for her. Soon HTC, Nokia and Samsung placed orders with her. Then in 2007, Apple entered the market with the iPhone, which has a keyboard-enabled glass touchscreen. Apple picked just as less technology as its supplier. Consequently, Ms. Jobs invested heavily in new facilities and skilled technicians. Within 5 years, she set up manufacturing plants in 3 cities. Later on, she started to work for making lenses that Motorola company Raspberry 3 in 2003. Within just 4 years of time here, she got a very good opportunity from Apple. Later on, she also got many other offers, and here as a result, she happened to invest more money for the facilities and the skillful, that talented or reputed workers. And she opened 3 more branches in the cities. Today, there are several competitors in the area. Less technology still remains a Taiwan player. Ms. Zhao is very hands-on with her job. She still tools the factory floor and sits down at the machines to work them herself. This is her way of finding and fault in the process of equipment that are in use. She expects the same amount of dedication from her employees as well. Most of the labor that she employs for checking glass are women. And here, even though there are many particular competitors in any particular field, we find that competitor, the quality products which are produced by that particular company could get more opportunities. This happened in the life of Ms. Jack and Faye, and she maintained the same quality lenses producing for that mobile phones. And here, that made her to be one of the topmost companies. And here, after getting that popularity and richness, many particular people can quit or just give up their monitoring task. But she continued to monitor each and every work in her own, and she expected the same from her employees. In the factory, glass is cut, ground down to size, bored and polished to give each plate a transparent finish. Then the plates are strengthened in potassium iron bore, painted and cured. Finally, they are cleaned and coated with anti-smudge and anti-reflection film. Joy is obsessive about the standards maintained in her factory. From her office, a door leads to an apartment. She uses this apartment to rest so that she can have access to the factory floor day and night. Here, in this particular paragraph, you can find another word, obsessive. Very particular, not rigid. Here, in this particular paragraph, you come to know that how that glasses are made for that mobile phones. And here, Joe wanted to expect the same standard in the factory from her employees. And here, there was the accessibility, that availability, which that open door towards her apartment, in which she could use it to take a rest, and she wanted to be available at any time to serve for her company. In spite of all the success she has achieved, Joy is relatively less known, even in her own country, China. She rarely grants any interviews or makes public appearances. Her employees know her to be fastidious and observant of the smallest details. She notices a manager slouching at a meeting and asks him to sit straight. Yet, she exudes charm and humility. She remembers where she comes from and does not take her present position for granted. She recalls that in her village, most girls did not have the option of going to middle school. They would be engaged or married at a very early age. Jo chose to work and run a business. And it is a choice she never regrets. And yeah. After reaching to heights and fulfilling the dreams, everyone feels proud of that and happy, and most of the people feel arrogant or attitudinal. But Jack Canfe is not the kind of person. She was very down to earth. She was very humble. All things and are presented here. Nowadays we can find that here with very just simple effort we want to get the popularity among the public. We want to become a public figure. But she was not such a kind. She rarely present interviews, and here she also she never forget about her base or foundation. She wanted to serve for women, and she continued the same thing till her entire life. And here what she has taken to serve for her family and become popular in her field, she made it and reached to her position. This particular lesson teaches about how to face any particular hurdles, overcome them with dedication, devotion and commitment. This is very important and inspirational story about Ms. Jack Canfe to entire school. Thanks.